The mind is stronger than we think. Its ability to transcend the consciousness of a person allows its beholder to experience their own imaginations.
Wow, Deacon, why would you even buy this?
You know we're saving money.
This is all your fault, and you're blaming this on me? I told you I should have taken a chance to go out brother and brother, and yet here we are struggling with our finances.
Are we really going over this again? I told you, I can't let you go to a foreign land just because it pays better.
You're my savior here. Just let me be the breadwinner of this family.
And look at what that got us right now! Why can't you just let me provide for the family for once?
In a world draped in shades of grey, I found sanctuary between the lines, where each page painted a vibrant escape from the monotony of my reality.
Huh? Am I dreaming?
Canvas of endless skies, vibrancy whispers never denies. Open it dreams at every glance, a kaleidoscope of endless dreams. Did they just...
Is there a book?
Ever since that day when I was granted the ability to live through pieces of literature, I have been jumping from one book to another. I've witnessed all sorts of stories, from melancholic to cheerful ones.
Unfortunately, the characters can't be the same. But it's kinda annoying when you're already in the climax and your time inside the book runs out.
Ah! It's getting good!
However, there's this one book I've always been fond of. No matter how many times I read its story, I would always find myself coming back in an attempt to see one of its characters.
For the upcoming contest.
I've been polishing my piece for days. Actually, I'm excited and nervous at the same time.
Don't worry too much. I know you've got this. We are all cheering you on. Good luck!
Ma, I'm going out. I'm going home late.
You want, Troy? I really don't care. Can't you see I have a lot on my plate right now?
Good morning, class. I hope you're all ready for a new discussion today. We are going to explore a topic as vast as the universe itself, life. But first, I want you to answer this question. How would you describe the beauty of life?
Yes, Miss Patalud?
Life is like a puzzle with lots of pieces. Each piece can make us happy, help us grow, or bring us closer to others. Sometimes, it's the little things that make us feel good. And other times, it's the big experiences But no matter what, life is always giving us chances to learn, have fun, and appreciate everything.
Very well said, Estrella. By the way, is your presentation for the upcoming contest going well? You know how much is at stake here, so make sure you don't disappoint us.
They should have chosen me instead of her.
Yeah, you are definitely way better. I don't know what they saw in, to be honest.
Beneath the clouds, where memories bloom, she's the sun, dispelling all gloom. Her laughter, a heavenly sight, whispers rhythms of moonlight. Wait, has this happened before? Or maybe I skipped a few pages and never noticed.
Hey, are you okay? You seem nervous.
Yeah, I'm a bit nervous. I can't find my wristwatch.
I still have more time in this book. It doesn't hurt if I'll... Hold on. She wasn't supposed to win in this chapter as far as I can remember. Don't tell me I... The power to shape this tale is a gamble with the very essence of your capabilities.
Tell me something. When the rain falls on my face, how do you quickly replace?
Hi, I'm Troy. Nice to meet you.
A golden summer.
Hi. Nice
smile.
Do I look intimidating to make you fluster like that?
No, not at all. Just, I'm not good at introductions.
Don't worry. I get nervous meeting new people too. We can be nervous together if you want.
Well, I'm here to congratulate you. Congrats on winning.
Thank you, Troy. I really appreciated that you watched me perform. But I gotta go. My friends are waiting for me. Oh, wait. What grade and section are you from? I haven't seen you here before.
Well, that's a secret that you need to find out.
If you're a vegetable, you'd be a cucumber. And if I were a vegetable, I'd be a corny one.
Hey, don't laugh. I'm trying my best.
You have potential, you know. You should join our poetry club.
No, I shouldn't.
Why not? I mean, you never know until you try. And... you can use someone with your funny and
my hand and gently calm me down.
Poetry isn't really my thing. I'm not sure if I'll fit in there.
It's not about fitting in. It's all about expressing yourself. And who knows where it may lead. Plus, it's a great way to meet new people and make friends.
I'm just not sure if I could handle putting myself on the joy you make me feel when I'm inside your universe. You hold me like I'm the one who's precious. I hate to break it to you, but it's just the other way around. You can thank your stars all you want, but I'll always be the lucky one.
Yes, I totally understand, but stepping out of your comfort zone can be a good thing. And who knows, you might find a new side of yourself you never knew existed.
It's just that growing up, no one will hear me out. No one really listened to me. So I tend to keep things to myself.
Was it hard? I can't imagine how tough that must have been for you. Feeling unheard can be incredibly isolating.
Yeah. I guess that's why I've never learned to express my thoughts. It's like a defense mechanism now, you know?
I understand, but sometimes allowing yourself to be vulnerable, even just a little, can make a difference. I'll always be the lucky
one. Hey, have you seen Ella?
Ella? Oh, you mean that cheater? Huh. She didn't show up today.
What? What do you mean cheater?
Didn't you hear? Someone told us that she plagiarized her poem in the competition. What a two-faced girl acting all holy and nice.
Ella!
When she's just a cunning person, thirsty for fame.
I'm just like that. I've witnessed her go through the pain over and over again, as if she's stuck in a time loop. The more I try to change each ending, the worse they get. There has to be a way. I must find a way.
Ella, I just want to ask, have you heard of stories about a world different from yours?
What do you mean?
Look, Ella, I'm not sure if you'll believe me, but I'm not really from here. The moment we met, I was merely an observer of your story. My ability to jump from different books has become my form of escapism. And now, I'm stuck here because I attempted to change your storyline. You weren't supposed to win that day. We are currently in a book and I've witnessed how your story ends. I just don't want to witness losing you over and over again, despite my attempts of altering each ending.
Will you come with me, Ella?
I won't mind experiencing a space-altering adventure that I can only read in fiction.
So that's a deal then.
What if it doesn't work?
Don't worry. The mind is stronger than we think. Its ability to transcend the consciousness of a person allows its beholder to experience our own imaginations, as they become our very own reality. On the count of three, I want you to close your eyes and hold onto these tightly. In 3, 2, 1.
Try, this is not the right time to play hide and seek.
My dearest Ella, by the time you read this letter, I will be long gone. I know that what I did was wrong, but I could not bear to see you suffer anymore. I would rather be imprisoned inside these pages than live my miserable life seeing you in agony. You have brought so much joy into my life. I have watched you from afar, and I have seen the strength and beauty in you. You are the reason why I chose to stay in the whispers of sunshine. Thank you for being my light in my dark world. Thank you for giving me hope and for making me believe in life again. As you step into a new world, I hope that you find happiness and peace. I will not be there to see it, but I know that you will keep me in your heart. Thank you for everything, Ella. You have made my life worth living, even if it only existed in my mind. Forever yours, Troy.
Since I first set foot in your world, I met people who took me in and made me feel like I belonged in an alienated place. I didn't tell them any of my history and have merely used the excuse of having amnesia to hide my true origins. I still go to the place that led you to me, hoping I'd see you there. Maybe one day you'd be there. The thought of it keeps me alive. As I read the book I once was a part of, I realized how much you've seen to sacrifice yourself for me. Thank you for setting me free, Troy. I'll forever hold on to and relive every moment we had together to create a story that unfolds with the happy ending you truly deserve. Strange. The eyes that once looked at me, removed with emotions, now seem empty. Only the vacancy of my being.
Place. Is something wrong? Oh.